two records ago. And it came out, the day it came out, all of a sudden my Twitter feed blew up. And people were like, oh my God, Taylor Swift stole your lyrics. No, stole your song. And I go, dude, people are so crazy. This never happened. And I knew that Taylor Swift was a fan because she used to write my lyrics on her arm and I was super flattered. So this is an honest to God how the story went. So all day I'm getting these tweets from people that are like, dude, she's got your song. So I go, I want to listen. So I put the song on and I'm listening and I'm like, this song sounds nothing like anything I've ever done. This is incredible. What is everyone's problem? But I appreciate their sort of vigilance, but like, and then I come across a lyric in the song that happens to be in the song I saw. And the lyric was in her song. And I was super flattered. Like I was like, oh my God, you're the biggest star in the world. Totally stole my lyric. I was like, dude, I was literally at my desk downstairs. I called up to my wife. I'm like, dude! And the lyric was, I'll forget about you long enough to forget why I need to, right? So her lyric was slightly different, but it was the same sentiment, right? Which is sort of a unique sentiment, if I do say so myself. So it was, I'll forget about you long enough to forget why I need to. So I'm like, off the wall psyched, right? Because I'm like, you know, I know I'm super famous and everything. But when somebody on that next rung, Prince, you know what I mean, Taylor Swift, you know, you look up and you're like, we're just looking around at all my, hey, Billy Joel, how you doing? Anyway, so I'm super psyched. I'm like, oh my God, dude, Taylor Swift took my lyric. How cool is this? And then like a small, after about 15 minutes of being like, oh yeah, about 7% of me was like, what the fuck? There was 93% of me was like, this is so rad. Like, because I know I look like a pillar of confidence to you. Sometimes, no. So I have, you know, you have this hole in you and you getting validation from someone like that is super rad. Then there was 7% of me that was like, dude, she totally took my lyric and didn't like give me props or didn't like, I was like, So this is very small. So then I let it go. Everything's cool. Then two or three days later, I'm sitting with my friend Sam, and we're writing songs, and I go, you know what's crazy? I really wish that I could tweet, I'm Pete from Fall Out Boy, I'm friends with Pete, and Pete tweets these things out, like very like cryptic shit, and people lose their mind. So I tweet cryptic things, and people are like, what? I'm very literal people on Twitter. So I said, dude, I wish that I could tweet something like super like crazy and like obtuse and people would be like, ooh, what does he mean? So then we keep talking, I go, dude, did I tell you this Taylor Swift story? Like, how rad is this? She totally took my lyric, that's great, oh great. And he's like, that's cool. And then I said, she's a fan, man. She's definitely a fan, and now she's a thief, right? Like I said that. And I said, and how cool is that? And he's like, dude, that's a tweet. And I went, what are you talking about? And he's like, I think I underestimated how social media worked. He goes, dude, just tweet, she's a fan. She's definitely a fan, and now she's a thief. And I go, okay. So I wrote this, I swear to God this happened. So I'm like, she's definitely a fan. She's like, are you sure people aren't gonna get mad at it? He's like, dude, hit send. So I go, all right, you know, nobody knows. I haven't said a word about Taylor Swift ever, right? So like, nobody knows. This is in a vacuum in my mind. So I hit send and it goes off into the world, right? And I'm just like, this is great. Like, how cool is that? I wonder what people are gonna say. Dude, it was like an avalanche of 12-year-old hatred. Never seen more venomous, more evil things coming at me from the computers of the youth of America. It was unbelievable. Somehow they put two and two together and they just started just destroying me. So I turned to Sam, this is after lunch. I go, let's see what everybody's doing. Oh my God! It's like things like, go die, you're a has-been, I wish you could get AIDS, like crazy. Like I swear to God, like the most vile things. So I'm like, dude, forget this. So I delete the tweet. I'm like, this is not worth it. Life is too short. So then about, 6 days later, It like, the way the internet works is it hit like another pocket of humanity somewhere. So it stopped, like the sort of the cavalcade of hatred stopped once I deleted the tweet. And then it must have like, hey, it just hit Malaysia. And then all of a sudden another, like 6 days later, my Twitter feed just fills with people being like, you're the worst, you're has been, you're terrible. So then I get mad. So then I'm just like, you know what? And I still, not really knowing how social media works, I tweet at Taylor Swift. And I say, I love that a bunch of 12-year-olds are getting mad at me because I wrote, I saw, a bunch of Taylor Swift fans are getting mad at me because I wrote, I saw in 2003. Send. I'm like, oh, this will show them. I mean, not only did it not show them, but the hate was just, it was relentless. If before it was a trickle, now it was like tsunami. And it's just flooding in. And I'm like, oh my God, oh my, what am I gonna do? I'm just like, you know what, forget these people. And I put my phone away and I'm driving home and my phone rings and I go, hey, what's going on? Dude, you're on the front page of Gawker. And I was like, what's Gawker? And they were like, oh, dude. And then, ring, hello? You're on the front page of Perez Hilton, huh? Grand People Magazine, from Spin, all of a sudden, the most press I've ever gotten in my life. And the way they did it was all of a sudden, it was a picture of me, a picture of her, and it said, folk rocker. I take umbrage with that, but I'll just, you know, whatever. I'm reading it, and what happens is, every magazine, one person writes it, and every other outlet just takes exactly what they say and posts. I've never experienced anything like it. So I'm going, and it says, folk rocker Matt Nathanson accuses Taylor Swift of thievery. And it has both the tweets. Like somehow they went back in time, and they took a screenshot of the first tweet and a screenshot of the second tweet, and they put it up. And then they let the Mensa winners of America comment. So it was like genius after genius giving their opinion about something I wasn't even a full story. So every comment was like super pro Taylor, super anti me, and it was everywhere, everywhere. And so I start reading it. No, I appreciate it. Thank you, but that's, I don't need it. Hold on. So it's incredible. So I'm reading these things and I'm like, wow, man, this is crazy. And my manager goes, too bad we don't have a record to promote. And I was like, I said, I think this is how they do it in the world. It's like, I'm marrying Kim Kardashian and I have a record, you know? And I don't know, I don't really play that game. So all of a sudden I was like, oh, so long story longer. Not sure Taylor Swift's a super big fan of me anymore. And which is fine. But the other part of it is that if you just Google me and like just put T next to my name in the Google search, Matt Nathanson, it's just incredible. And you get to read these incredible, the best was like the humanity of like people being like, oh, I think that guy just wanted to, oh, maybe they slipped together. I was just like, oh my God. So that was fun, and this is the song. This song, for some reason, I met Ed Sheeran a couple before this incident. And he was super nice, and he's like, should run for president of the world. And he goes, dude, I love your Beneath These Fireworks record. It's like one of my favorite records. And he goes, and I saw it's the best song. And then, and now, then it's... Thanks, Ed. And it's amazing, the look in your eyes, like you could save me, but you won't even try. And then you tell me again, how everything will be alright. And if I told you that I'm sorry, would you tell me you were wrong? Or would you hold me down forever? I came to you for answers. I saw pictures in my head. I swear I saw you opening up again. Cause that would be heavenly if maybe you just rescue me now.
surrounded. You spill alive and brand new. And I forget about you long enough to forget why I need to. I saw pictures in my head, and I swear I saw you opening up again. 'Cause I was